It's the middle of the 12th century. In the Holy Land, the Knights Hospitaller are intent on building an impenetrable castle to defend Christian territory against a Muslim enemy. The first challenge the knights face is the ground itself. The rock here is basalt. It's extremely hard and difficult to cut into the precise blocks needed to realize the knight's ambitious vision. The ideal material is limestone, and the knights have located a deposit a few kilometers away. But shaping limestone to build a castle requires enormous skill. To find out more, I've come here to Guédelon in France, where a castle is currently being constructed using entirely medieval building techniques. Well, you can hear what they're doing here before you see it. This telltale sound, they're turning the big, roughly cut rocks from the quarry, limestone in this case, to finely hewn stone, finely finished stone. And they do so using these amazing molds that are hanging up here. Every single one of these is a different shape for a stone that will fit into that wonderful castle behind us here. Let's see if I can have a go. Can I have a... Oh, thank you. Here we go. Do I need the safety spectacles? Here we go. This type of stone can be carved to produce a very fine finish. Chisels, punches, and hammers are used to shape it. The time it takes to cut a stone depends on its size and complexity.
I've got a lot to go, haven't I?
Basic blocks can be produced at a rate of 3 or 4 a day, but more intricate designs can take up to 4 days to finish.
This is where the fine tuning comes in. She's just doing the last, the finishing, before it heads up there and takes its place in the castle.
In medieval times, a stonecutter's wage was based on their skill and on their speed.
Okay, I got it. You just don't realize until you're doing this how every block in these massive castles is prepared with this same professionalism, this loving care and attention. I mean, I've always admired these castle builders, but this is just extraordinary.